Hi, I'm Raja Sen, and today we'll be talking about the big Republic Day release, Manikarnika, the Queen of Jhansi, directed by and starring Kangana Ranaut. Here's how the film scores. +5 for Kangana Ranaut. Ranaut is absolutely flat out fantastic in this film, and she's a one-woman army as she takes on the British. There are other people around there, but it's like watching Sachin bat in the 90s. She's the only one that matters. She seems to be doing all the work herself in this film. She's there in pretty much every frame. She looks absolutely fierce and fantastic. And there's a lot of energy she brings to the proceedings. It's really quite amazing to see her in this kind of form. Also, I find it interesting that Manikarnika is nicknamed Manu, which is quite like the Tanu Weds Manu films where the hero was called Manu. The message here is very clear. Kangana Ranaut does not need a man. -1 for the poor dialogues. There's a lot of talk about Azadi and Inqilab and all that stuff you'd expect in a film like this, but the dialogues always seem too theatrical, abrupt, and don't seem to match the people speaking them. It all seems like lines written on the back of auto rickshaws, that sort of bad shayari, and it never really fits the film. -1 for the poor visual effects. The film is lavishly mounted, there are lots of extras, the costumes are good, but the special effects are wildly inconsistent. In some scenes, they look like they're in the heat of battle, and in some scenes, they look so obviously green-screened, it hurts. Takes you out of the illusion completely. -1 for the patchy storytelling. The film starts with all about character build-up and keeps giving us the story of the Rani of Jhansi, and the second half of the film is all about war, war, war. There is no balance between these two segments, and as a result, both parts seem longer than they are. +1 for the empowerment. This is a film about one warrior queen, but she's not the only one. The women in this film are waging war and making tough decisions, and they're the ones really giving the battle the heat. It's quite impressive to see this. We haven't really seen it on this scale in Hindi cinema before, and it's exciting. That makes it a total of 3 stars for Manikarnika, the Queen of Jhansi. It may have the simplistic impact of an Amar Chitra Katha book, but there's a lot to be said about a heroine truly worth celebrating. Please read the full review over at hindustantimes.com, and I'll see you next time.